Hi, teacher.
Hello.
How are you?
How was your weekend?
It's fine.
Okay, nice. And how is your progress on the platform?
In level four.
Wow, great.
Yes, teacher.
You are almost at the middle. No,
Yes.
Almost at the end.
I have this exam. The middle exam.
Okay, and how was it?
Yeah.
How was the middle exam?
It's fine. No me costó mucho, solo como dos o tres cositas nada más, pero de ahí, easy.
But you can do it again.
Ah, de verdad.
Yes. As far as I know.
Good evening, miss.
Good evening.
Okay.
So if you already have seen which one are the problems, you can go and do it again.
Okay.
To get the time.
Okay, voy a verificar.
Hi, Jancy. How is your progress in the platform?
Hi, Carla.
How is the progress in the platform?
Hi, sorry.
Yes, me.
How is your progress in the platform?
Yes, almost. I finished almost the unit three.
Oh, great.
Yes.
That's the unit that
only the midterm
seeing today. And the midterm exam is after the third section.
In this week.
Yes, this week. Okay. Yes. Hi, Floridalia. How was your weekend?
Hi, teacher. Bastante, ¿cómo se diría? Muy descansado. Ay, no sé cómo decir.
Ah, great.
Okay, great. The great weekend.
Very relaxed. Okay, relaxed.
Very relaxed.
Nice. Now, this weekend is when I was working more on my gardening because I finished the crops bed and I got all the Tetra Pak boxes and cut them in order to ¿cómo sería? Wrap inside the crop bird. I put the metallic thing of the Tetra Pak heading to where the sand and soil will be. O sea, forré todo el la cosa esa de madera que estoy haciendo, como la. Eso normalmente se hace solo así alrededor del pedazo de tierra, como para hacer que levante un poco, pero siempre se ocupa de la misma tierra donde uno está, solo como para hacer un borde. Pero ajá, como en mi caso la tierra no sirve, entonces yo no voy a poner la tierra encima de la tierra que no sirve, sino que yo estoy dejándolo incluso así como patitas para que quede como levantadito. Porque como aquí la tierra de por sí no sirve y además cuando llueve se inunda. Y se inunda porque la tierra no sirve. O sea, es como que fuera un ladrillo de duro. Entonces, todo el agua, en vez de irse hacia adentro, se empoza y se hace como que fuera un lago lo que es el jardín. Entonces, yo no voy a tener mis plantas empozadas cada vez que llueve. ¿Verdad?
Entonces, take a picture, miss.
¿Ah?
Take a picture.
I will send you a picture on WhatsApp.
Yes.
Sí, y para que vean cómo estoy de carpintera también. Okay. All the material I am using is recycled. O sea, todo lo estoy reciclando, reusando, porque unos vecinos aquí botaron todos los tablones, o sea, los tablones que estoy ocupando para hacer alrededor. Los botaron unos vecinos y yo les dije, miren, eso no lo van a ocupar. No, ya es basura. ¿Me lo puedo llevar? Sí, lléveselo. Lo fui a recoger antes de que pasara el camión de la basura y me los traje para acá, para el patio. Y de ahí el otro poco de madera, que son así como el montón de listones, esos me los vendieron a $2 en una ferretería aquí. $2, pero el pocotote, llené todo el pickup con eso. Y entonces, ahí estoy, con eso estoy trabajando. Entonces, pero $2 para poder tener mis camas de cultivo, yo siento que valió la pena. Y de ahí acarrear de donde mi vecina, que ella como que hizo muros y cosas así. Entonces, todo lo que ocuparon para sostener, para poner la mezcla y todo, todos esos tablones, después los descartaron. Entonces, hoy van a servir para hacer mis camas de cultivo. Ahí les voy a mandar fotos. Ok, let's start then. First of all, since we will have the midterm test this week, I have my thought first. Education is the manifestation of perfection, present already in man. Divinity is the manifestation of the religion already in man. Swami Vivekananda. This is an Indian man. Well, education is the manifestation of perfection present already in man. So education is how we reflect the perfection in man. And divinity is the manifestation of the religion in man, okay? Because according to him, everything is already in man, but we have to take it out, okay, from inside. So all the good things are within the man, and he has certain reason, because remember that God make us to his pattern, okay? So we have inside us the good things, but also we have the bad things, and it depends on us what we wanted to be manifest, the good things or the bad things. O sea, todos nosotros podemos ser grandes líderes y buenos trabajadores si quisiéramos serlo. Pero también cualquiera de nosotros puede ser un gran maleante, un gran asesino, si quisiéramos serlo, ¿verdad? O sea, dentro del ser humano hay cosas buenas y hay cosas malas, pero depende de nosotros qué es lo que pulimos y qué es lo que queremos resaltar, ¿verdad?
Tenemos libre albedrío.
Exacto, exacto. Now, wait. Okay, now, since we will be on middle term exam to, this week, I want to check on some things that we have seen during last week. For example, In section one, we were talking about the use of verb to be and the yes, no questions using verb to be and their answers. So remember that verb to be is, we study it apart because it's different than the other verbs. It doesn't require an auxiliary in order to make the negative sentences and the interrogative sentences. But the other verbs require do or does according to the person that we are talking about. But in the case of verb to be, it is auxiliary by itself. For example, are you free? Are is the verb to be for you. Is David from Mexico? Is the verb to be for third person singular. And in the case of am, is the verb to be for I. Okay, so here we have, are you free? Repeat, please. Are you free?
Are you free?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am.
No, I'm not.
No, I'm not.
Remember that when you have yes, no questions, you only need to answer by yes or no. But in English, we don't use only yes or no. When we say yes, we use also the personal pronoun and the auxiliary, okay? In this case, verb to be. In when we say no, the personal pronoun, the verb to be, and not, okay, to answer. Is David from Mexico? Yes, he is. Is David from Mexico?
Is David from Mexico?
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
No, he's not.
No, he isn't.
No, he isn't. Is best class in the morning?
Is best class in the morning?
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't. In the case of, are you and Beth in the same class?
Are you and Beth in the same class?
Yes, we are.
No, we are not.
Are your classes interesting?
Yes, they are. No, they aren't.
Okay, tomorrow we will check all the things from lessons from section two. Now, in section three, the first objective is that in these lessons, participants will listen to conversation about the administrative while chopping. Okay. Los estoy queriendo mutear y no puedo. Hay alguien ahí que tiene sonido y me está interfiriendo. Okay, thank you. Now, Steve, first follow the reading, and then we will repeat. Oh, look at those earrings, Maria. They're perfect for you. These red ones? I'm not sure. No, the yellow ones. Oh, these. Yellow isn't really a good color for me. Well, that necklace isn't bad. Which one? That blue one, right there. How much is it? It's 42. That's expensive. Hey, let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday. Well, nice. Okay, now repeat after me. Oh, look at those earrings, Maria. They're perfect for you.
Oh, look at those earrings, Maria.
These red ones?
These red ones?
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, these? Yellow isn't really a good color for me.
Yellow isn't really a good color for me.
Well, that necklace isn't bad.
Well, that necklace isn't bad.
Which one? That blue one, right there.
That blue one, right there.
How much is it? It's 42. That's expensive.
It's 42. That's expensive.
Hey, let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday.
Hey, happy birthday.
Okay, now volunteers, who wants to be first? Nadie se voluntea aquí.
Yes, me.
Okay. Now, Yancy Mayen and Veronica. Go ahead. Yancy first and Veronica then, later. Veronica, have you seen the ones is used for plural and one is used for singular? Okay. As I told you last week.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, go ahead.
Oh, look ahead. Oh, look at those earrings, Maria. They are perfect for you.
This red one? I'm not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
Veronica.
Es your turn, Veronica.
Creo que se frizó. Bueno. Well. Ah, ya, ya está ahí. Ajá. Pero. No, si dijiste tu parte, no se te escuchó porque estabas frizada.
Es que no veo todavía la otra pantalla. Tengo frizado. Permítame.
Ah, no. Espérate. Ok.
No, pero es que nos quedamos pendientes con esta todavía.
Pero como te frizaste, no se te...
I'm going to start, miss.
Ajá, okay. Start again.
Oh, look at those ears, Maria. They are perfect for you.
These red ones, I'm not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, this yellow is really a good color for me.
Well, that nickel isn't bad. That nickel isn't
Which
bad.
Which one?
Necklace.
That blue one, right there. How much is it?
It's 42. That's expensive.
Hey, let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday.
Okay, good. Now, other two volunteers. Janet and Carla Albergue. Janet first.
Mami, estoy en clases. Estoy en clases.
Oh, look at those earrings. Maria, they perfect for you?
These red ones? I'm not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, these? Yellow isn't really a good color for me.
Well, that necklace is bad.
Which one?
That blue one right there. How much is
it? It's 42. That's expensive.
Hey, let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday.
Okay, thank you. Now, other two volunteers. Lisette, Esmeralda, and who else? And Josue Gonzalez. Then Josue, you first, and then Lisette.
Oh, look at these earrings, Maria. They're perfect for you.
This red one? I'm not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, this? Yellow is really a good color for me.
Next. Well, that necklace is bad.
Which one?
This blue one right there. How much it is?
Is 42 that's expensive?
Hey, let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday.
Okay. Is that blue one right there? How much is it? How much is it? You say how much it's is and it's it. First verb to be and then it. Okay. Now other two volunteers. Lourdes Gonzalez, could you help us? And
yes.
Jemima, please.
Yes.
Okay. Lourdes first and then Jemima.
Okay. Oh, look at those earrings. Maria, they are perfect for you.
These red ones, I am not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, this. Yellow isn't really a good color for me.
Well, that necklace isn't bad.
Which one?
The blue one right there. How much is it?
It's 42. That's expensive.
Hey, let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, Jacqueline Patricia and Abigail Villalta, please. First. Jacqueline first, and then the guy.
Okay. Oh, look at this earring, Maria. They perfect for you.
These red ones? I'm not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, this. Yellow isn't really a good color for me.
Well, that necklace is seen bad.
Which one?
That blue one right there. How much is it?
It's 42. That's expensive.
Hey, let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, other two volunteers. Remberto, could you help us?
Okay.
Okay. And Melida Sarai, please.
Okay.
Go ahead, Remberto.
Oh. Look at those earrings, Maria. They're perfect for you.
These red ones? I am not sure.
No, the yellow ones.
Oh, these. Yellow isn't really a good color for me.
Well, that necklace isn't bad.
Which one?
That blue one right there. How much is it?
It's 42. That's expensive.
Hey, then get a Let me get it for you. It's your birthday present. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Thank you very much. Okay. Now, someone else wants to do it? ¿Alguien más que quiera hacerlo? No volunteers? Well, go ahead. By the end of this lesson, participants will be able to use demonstrative pronouns. These, that, those. Okay? The easier way to learn this is this is close, that is far, okay? Singular both. This close, that far. And in the case of these and those, this is close, those are far, okay? But it's plural. These, those, this, that, okay? Y aquí lo pueden ver, near, this and these, far, that and those, singular, this and that, plural, this and those, this is, these are, that is, those are. Now repeat after me.
These are.
That is.
That is.
Those are. Again. This is.
This is.
These are.
These are.
That is.
That is.
Those are.
Those are.
Okay. Here we have this for singular close. If you notice, it's almost touching the apple. That is singular, but far. Okay. Now, for example, I like this apple. Repeat, I like this apple.
I like that apple.
These and those. I like these apples.
I like these apples.
Tiene problemita porque no le pusieron la S a apples. Si están siendo plurales y están poniendo que son varias, tiene que llevar el plural, o sea, apples, con S al final. Entonces, I like those apples.
I like those apples.
Si fijan, lo raro es que sí pusieron el dibujo de que eran varias, pero se les olvidó cambiarlo. Bien. Ahora. Demonstrative. And once. Demonstrative is this, that, these, those. Okay. Those are the demonstratives. And once. One is used for singular. And once is used for plural. Now, repeat after me. How much is this necklace?
How much is this necklace?
How much is this one?
How much is this one?
How much is that necklace?
How much is that necklace?
How much is that one?
How much is that one?
Which one?
Which one?
The blue one.
The blue ones.
It's 42.
It's 42.
Por ahí escuché a alguien decir once. Estamos hablando de una sola cosa, es one. Okay. Ahora sí, hoy sí vamos con once. How much are these earrings?
How much are these earrings?
How much are these ones?
How much are those earrings? How much are those earrings?
How much are those? Which ones? The yellow ones. They're 18.
Day 18.
Demonstratives one and once. We use one and once when talking about choosing or having more than one option. Is that your car? Which one? The red one or the blue one? The red one. Yes, it is. That is in the case of one. When we use ones, it's when it is plural. For example, are those your children? Which ones? The ones that are running. Yes, they are. Okay. O sea, the ones, which ones, cuando nos estamos refiriendo a más de uno. Hoy vamos a trabajar en la plataforma. El Vaya, hay alguien que tiene la televisión ahí, por favor, se mutea. Gracias. Now, let's check. Look at the pictures below and complete these conversations using demonstratives. One and once. Okay. Now, we have here two human and a man and a woman. This is the clerk. Okay, this is the clerk. Now, excuse me, how much?
Are those jeans?
Which ones?
Ones.
Okay. Do you mean these? No, the light blue
ones.
Oh,
they are
59.95. I like that backpack over there. How much?
It is.
Uh-huh. Which one?
The red one.
It's $27.50, but the green
one is
only $22.25. Okay. Y está correcto. Bien. Entonces, let's continue with the class. Okay. Remember that I gave you the list of verbs. Okay. We are going to work with them. Do you have them? ¿Las tienen por ahí? La lista de verbos que les mandé. Hello. Okay. Entonces, we have different verbs there. And I remember I asked you to use, to put beside the third person singular for each of the verbs. Permítanme, voy a sacar yo también mi listado. A ver. Entonces lo vamos a hacer aquí juntos, ¿ok? Y después vamos a hacer algo que se llama transformation drills. Pero primero revisemos esto. Bueno, para empezar, el be es el infinitive del verbo to be, ¿verdad? Entonces, el presente de esto sería am, is y are. Entonces, la tercera persona sería is, ¿verdad? Para become, becomes. Solo se le agrega S. A todos estos, a la mayoría, solo se les agrega S, hasta by. Entonces, solo agreguen S, 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 ahí. Cuando lleguen a catch, ahí tienen que cumplir la segunda regla, que es la que dice que cuando termina en O, S, H, C, H, X, Z, se le agrega ES. Entonces ahí sería catches. Vaya, y después seguimos solo S, solo S, solo S. Y después llegamos a do, que termina en O. Entonces, ¿qué tienen que agregar ahí?
ES.
ES, ES, do, does, Ok, do does. Entonces, con drink, drive, eat, feel, flight, find. Con todas esas, solo se agrega S.
Entonces, go,
llegamos.
Go is, yes, go.
Sí, con go sería yes, pero también con fly. Con fly se cambia, acuérdese que cuando termina, when it ends y with a consonant before, we change the y for I and add yes.
Yes.
Flies.
Yes.
Flies. Then forget and forgives, SS, get gets, give gives, and go goes.
Goes, goes.
Goes, así como que fuera gobierno de El Salvador. Then, in the case of have, we have here, this is a special case. When have, we have has.
Have, has.
No, no se pone haves. Sino que has.
Have.
Has. Uh-huh. Entonces, con here, sí sería here, hears, heart, hearts, keep, keeps, grow, grows, know, knows, learn, learns, live, lives, lend, lends, let, lets, lose,
loses,
make, makes, mean, means, meet, meet, pay, pays. Pay. Acuérdese que cuando termina en Y, pero está precedido por una vocal, todo se le agrega S. Pay, pays. Put, puts. Read, reads. Run, runs. Says, says. See, sees. Sell, sells. Sing, sings. Sit, sits. Sleep, sleeps. Speak, speaks. Spend, spends. Stand, stands, still, still, sweep, sweeps, take, takes,
teach,
teaches. Ahí sí, se le agrega S.
Okay.
Tell, tells, think, thinks, typewrite, typewrites, understand, understands, and write, writes. ¿Estamos bien? Bien, entonces ahora, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Este, uno de ustedes va a escoger cualquiera de esta lista de verbos, ¿verdad? Para hacer una oración. Y va a hacer la oración. No se preocupe, yo le ayudo. Acuérdese que la oración tendría que ser sujeto, verbo y complemento. Y el complemento tiene que estar de acuerdo al verbo. Porque no va a decir usted, qué sé yo, caballo. Si está diciendo que se comió, ¿verdad? No va a decir que se comió un caballo, ¿verdad? Entonces tiene que ser de acuerdo a lo que usted se esté refiriendo. En cambio, sí podría decir que con respecto a caballo, si usted dice ride, ¿verdad? Que lo montó. I ride a horse, ¿verdad? Monto caballo. Ok. Entonces, este, escojan un verbo, cualquiera de ustedes, voluntario. Un voluntario. Ok, Janet del Rosario. Escoja un verbo. Vamos a hacer la oración primero. Oración afirmativa. Presente simple. Usted escoge la persona gramatical que quiere hacer. Que no hay problema porque después vamos a hacer el transformation drill. Esto del transformation drill se lo voy a explicar. Digamos, si yo digo, este, I sell the house.
Yeah.
Y después en el transformation drill digo he. Entonces en lugar de decir
he sells,
sell, digo sells. He sells the house. Yes. ¿Verdad? Entonces ahí ya transformé.
En the third person.
Ya lo transformé en tercera persona. Pero si yo le digo, este, en lugar de decirle he, le digo negative, entonces yo diría I don't sell the house. ¿Verdad? Entonces ahí sería negativo. Negativa porque le estoy diciendo negative. Entonces hay que estar listo que qué es la transformación que yo le estoy pidiendo que haga. Porque podemos hacer transformación de cambiar la persona, ya sea de cualquiera de las otras personas a tercera persona en singular, o podemos hacer la transformación de que sea negativo o interrogativo. Entonces tenemos que estar listos de qué es lo que vamos a hacer. Y digamos, voy a empezar yo por decir algo. Entonces, menciono a la persona y le digo qué es lo que tiene que hacer. Por ejemplo, si yo digo, I speak English. Entonces digo, Verónica, she.
She speaks English.
Ok. Vaya, pero también yo podría decir, vaya, ahorita que ella dijo she speaks English, usted puede escoger a otra persona y le dice qué es la transformación que quiere, ya sea de persona o si quiere hacer negativo o interrogativo. Ok.
Ok.
Vaya, entonces usted escoge qué va a hacer ahorita con la oración. O si cambia de verbo, porque podría cambiar de verbo. Entonces tienen que cambiar, tienen que hacer otra oración. ¿Verdad? Dele.
I drink coke.
Ajá.
For dancing.
Dancing. Yes,
do you transformation for interrogative?
I drink coke, but interrogative.
Are you drink coke?
No. Do you drink?
Do you drink? No, no.
Es que acuérdese que para other than be no yes. Ocupa el verbo to be, sino que yes. El auxiliar do. Aquí les pongo, ¿vale? Aquí les pongo los ejemplos. Ahí tienen cómo se hace afirmativo, negativo, interrogativo.
Interrogativo. Uh-huh. Do you drink coke?
Uh-huh. Okay. Is correct, yes. Now, it's okay. Now, you choose another classmate and ask him what you want him to do.
Okay.
What transformation?
For Lourdes Gonzalez. You can use the verb typewrites. Typewrites. In the third person.
Right?
Mm-hmm. You choose if negative or affirmative.
She don't write. She's homework.
She doesn't.
Her homework.
She doesn't typewrite. She doesn't. Typewrite.
She doesn't
typewrite.
He that write.
Her homework.
Her homework.
Okay, thank you. Now choose your classmate and say the transformation.
Okay, the verb come and positive.
Affirmative. Okay.
Okay.
¿A quién quiere que lo haga?
I don't know. Jemima.
Ajá, Jemima. Jemima.
Repeat, please.
Ajá, no se dio cuenta que qué tenía que hacer. Dígale qué es lo que quiere que haga. Lourdes.
Una oración con el verbo come afirmativo.
Ok. Ve, como ella solo le está diciendo verb come, significa que puede ocupar cualquiera de las otras personas. Ok. Affirmative. Hello.
Hello.
Acuérdese que aquí acuérdese que estamos con other than be. De sujeto, verbo, complemento. Primero, ¿qué sujeto va a ocupar? Aquí están los sujetos y si no, también puede poner nombres. Primero escoja un sujeto.
Sí.
Vaya, he. Entonces, el verbo come no va a ser come, sino que sería
comes.
Sí. He comes. ¿Y a dónde quiere que llegue? Lo ponemos en el estadio. He comes to the stadium. O he comes to class. He comes to class. Okay, he comes to class. Vale, entonces ahora escoja un compañero y le dice qué transformación quiere que haga.
Verbo ring. Interrogativo.
Okay. ¿Y a quién va a escoger?
Carla Alvarenga.
Ok, Carla Alvarenga. O Carla Albergue.
Albergue.
Does he drink coffee?
Ok, thank you. Now choose your victim.
Floridalma. The verb go in third person in affirmative form.
Okay. Flor.
The verb
go.
Go.
In third person. Affirmative.
Affirmative form in third person.
Aquí tengo una copia.
De Rafael. Goes the park.
Rafael goes to the park.
Goes to the park.
Okay.
Yes.
Now you choose your victim.
Okay. Veamos quién es esta. A ver, Jacqueline Patricia. The bear, affirmative.
I am by to the chivo wallet.
I buy with the chivo wallet. Porque chivo. Buy es comprar. I buy with chivo wallet. Y a propósito, ha subido bastante. Yo estaba cobrando unas clases porque sí doy clases particulares de vez en cuando. Yo preparo para el TOEFL también, ¿verdad? Entonces estaba dando clases y el muchacho me dice, pero ¿cómo le hago para pagarle? Que no sé qué. Ah, con chivo wallet, le digo. Porque él no tenía trabajo y quería hacerse el examen porque para poder graduarse y poder conseguir trabajo. Entonces, y le digo yo, con la chivo wallet, le digo yo, le van a dar $30 de le van a dar $30, así que con esos $30 bien me pago unas cuantas clases. Así que así hicimos. Entonces hoy yo tengo, además de los $30, lo que ellos me pagaron, y cada vez se me va haciendo más y más y más y más. Eso sí, cuando baja se me va haciendo menos. Pero ahorita de los 30 que me dieron, ya no son 30, sino que 31 y algo. Y de lo que ellos me habían estado pagando, también ha subido. Entonces digo yo, wow, vale la pena. Ok. Choose your victim. Your classmate.
Joshua.
Joshua, ajá.
Rome. Sí, afirma.
¿Qué verbo, disculpa?
Rome, run.
Run, run, ok. Run, affirmative. Entonces, si te dice run, significa que es cualquiera de las otras personas, que no es tercera persona del singular. Porque si fuera tercera persona, te diría runs. Entonces, hace la oración, Josué González.
Excuse me, how do you spell runs?
R-U-N. Run.
R-U-M.
Run, correr.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I run every day in the morning.
Okay, I run every day in the morning. Now choose one of your classmates and say the transformation you want. Acuérdese que puede pedir también que le hagan esa oración en negativo o en interrogativo.
Excuse.
Okay.
I don't understand. Could you repeat that again?
We are doing transformation drills. Either you change the verb, so they have to change all the sentences, or you may ask the other classmate to change your sentence, which is I run every day in the morning, to negative or to interrogative.
Okay, in a negative?
Uh-huh, who?
I don't run.
Yes, who? ¿A quién le va a pedir que cambie para el negativo? Uh-huh.
Okay. Abigail Villalta.
Okay, Abigail, change I run every day in the morning to negative. Aquí tienen cómo son las transformaciones. Afirmativo, negativo, interrogativo. Ok. No está por ahí. Creo que no está quien usted pidió con razón. Cambie.
Dan Lourdes.
Lourdes González. Change I run in every day in the morning to negative sentence.
I don't run every day in the morning.
Okay, nice. Thank you. Now choose the other classmate.
Jancy Mayen.
Yes.
Okay. What's the transformation?
Fine.
Pay?
Fine. F-I-N-D. Negative.
Fine.
F-I-N-D. Encontrar. Mm-hmm. Fine.
Yes. En negative.
En negative.
Okay. She doesn't find...
Mm-hmm.
The keys.
She doesn't find the keys. Okay, that's classic. I like that. My car has a key. Okay, but I like that. This one has an alarm. So when I can't find the keys, I go to the car and I kick the wheel, and then it starts sounding, and I can find this. Cuando se le pega a la llanta del carro, empieza a sonar el carro y suena la alarma, entonces ahí puedo encontrar la llave. I love that. Okay, you have done a very good job. Han hecho un buen trabajo. Espero les haya gustado porque esto los hizo trabajar bastante, o sea, armando oraciones, right. Sus propias oraciones, ¿verdad? Pueden hacer ejercicios similares ustedes por escrito, ¿verdad? Agarran cualquier verbo, hacen la oración siguiendo el esquema, la fórmula. Y hacen el cambio de afirmativo a negativo a interrogativo, ¿verdad? Porque la mejor forma de aprender el inglés, al igual que la matemática, es practicando.
Yes.
Okay. We'll see you tomorrow.
I miss you.
Okay. Bye bye.
Bye.
Good night. Bye bye.
Good night.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye. Bye bye.